Hello and welcome, I'm Raghav and today we will learn how to create a Java project on Eclipse for iOS automation, and this will be very easy and very interesting and I will go very basic step by step. So we will set up our macOS for iOS automation, we will create an Eclipse project and add dependencies, we will add the code and desired capabilities for iOS automation in our project, set up the device or set up the simulator, and then we will start Appium server and then run our test. Now here, these two things, set up macOS for iOS automation and create an Eclipse project and add dependencies, this I have already covered in the earlier session. So if you go to my website, Automation Step by Step, and go to online courses, and if you go to Appium course here, it will take you to the Appium playlist on YouTube. And here you will find all these earlier videos. I will also copy this link and make it available in the notes. So you can see setting up your macOS for iOS automation and all these videos, you will find it here. So you can check that. And this is the link that you can go to and check all the videos. And we have also created in our earlier session a Eclipse project, and we have added the MAVEN dependency. So this is an Eclipse Java MAVEN project and we have also added testng. Now we will start to add the code in our Eclipse for iOS automation. So if I go to my Eclipse here, and I can show you, this is the project that we created. So Appium demo project is the project we created earlier, and this is a MAVEN project I created. And if I go to pom.xml, here I have added the dependencies for Appium Java client, the Selenium Java dependencies and testng, and testng plugin should already be added to Eclipse, all this we have learned earlier. And if I show you the src test java folder, here in the test folder we have created a base class and a test class. So in the base class we had created the desired capabilities for Android, and we have started the driver here, the Appium server we have connected here, and then in the test class we have created a test to go to google.com and add automation, then a second test to add Raghav, and then a third test for a login to an application. So now I will go back to my base class, and here you can see all these capabilities are for Android. Now we have to create capabilities for iOS, and for iOS you can get all these capabilities. I will just put it here and I will show you how exactly you can do this. So now I'm using the same project and I will create sections for iOS and Android, and in real world this is what you will need to do. Most of the times you will be using the same project, and in the same project you will be doing automation on Android as well as on iOS. And just in case you want to do specific on iOS and do not want Android, you can always just delete or comment out the Android capabilities and you can continue with iOS. So what I'm going to do is I will create a string variable called platform, and I will give it some name. For example, I can say Android or iOS here, and then I will say if, I will put a if condition, if platform dot equals ignore case Android. So if it is equal to Android, the platform name equals to Android, then use these capabilities, and else if platform dot equals ignore case is iOS, then I will use these capabilities. So I will just change this to iOS, and now it will go to, it will skip this section and come here, and here I can give the capabilities for iOS device. So here is what we have to give. I can just copy the same command here and I can just change it. So this is caps.set capability, and here, so this is because I have already created caps here, you can see desired capabilities, caps, new desired capabilities, and now because this is outside the if else block, I can use caps here as well as here. So I will say caps.set capability and a key and value. So here I have to set the platform name to iOS. I will say platform name is iOS, and if you go to Google and search for Appium desired capabilities, It will take you to the appium.io website, and here is a very good link. So here, sorry for that noise disturbance. So yes, you can see Appium desired capabilities, and you can see all this here: platform version, platform name, device name, app, etc. And when we want to do testing on a native app, we have to say app and the path to the .app or .ipa file. And here are all the general capabilities, Android only capabilities. And if you scroll more down, you will see iOS only. So this is something you can refer. I will also copy this and give it here in references. So you can refer these links. So I have added this, and as we have learned, I can also say set capability, and instead of putting a key here, I can refer it like capability type is an interface, and I can say platform name, and the value is iOS. Or I can also say caps.set capability mobile capability type, and again I will say value as iOS. So anything should work here. This is dot platform name. Anything should work here, and we have also seen this in the Android session as well. So for now, I'm just going to use the mobile capability type, and I'm saying here the platform name is iOS, and again I will say caps.set capability mobile capability type. I'm pressing control spacebar on my keyboard for auto completion, and here I have to say platform version as well. Now platform version will be your iOS version. So here we have to give the platform version. Now at this moment, you can connect your mobile device, your iOS device, to your system through a cable, and then you can get the details. Now in my case, I'm going to use a simulator. So if I go to simulator app, and just in case you get any issues here, you can always check my video where I have explained on how to set up automation, iOS automation on macOS. All this I have shown there, how to start simulator and everything. So here I have now, so simulator app is open. If I go to hardware and go to devices, I can see I can use so many simulators: iPhone 10, iPhone SE 7, then Apple TV and Apple Watch. As of now, I have this iPhone 10 and this is iPad Air. Both are already started, so let me just use this. So I'm using iPhone 10. Now when you connect a real device, you will get a prompt on your device to trust the connection. You can always trust it, and then you can go to your settings. So if you go to your settings and go to developer here, you can see a developer option, and make sure enable UI automation is enabled. And then you can also go to general, about, and here you will get the name of your phone. This is what we will use in the device name. You can use the device name as per your name, and then you can see the version. So here you can see this is 11.4 and the name is iPhone 10, which I am going to use. So I will say platform version is 11.4, and then I will again say caps.set capability mobile capability type, and I will say device name, and this is iPhone 10. I will say iPhone 10, and then now you can also give a UDID. So if you want to give the device ID, you can get that, and for that you can use these commands. So these are the commands to get the device details or ID, and I will also provide them here. So you can deploy this iOS deploy, you can get through npm, and then you can run this command. It will give you the device ID for a real device, and you can also run this command instruments minus s devices on your terminal. This will give you the details of all the devices, including real devices and simulators. So if I run this command on my terminal, it will give me a detail of all the devices, including simulators and the ID as well. So I can get the ID from here. So it will, you can see all the devices are listed out. And if I see iPhone 10, you can see this is the ID. So I can give a UDID like this. Although in case of simulators, you might not need it. I have already given the device name, so this should work fine. And I will just skip this. I will have this commands in the description, so you can refer it. And then browser name. So I will say, so this time I'm doing it on a browser. We will learn on a native app as well. So set capability. And I will say mobile capability type dot browser name. And here you can use any browser which is available on your phone. For now, I'm just saying Safari. So I want to run it on Safari, and that's it. And here you have the URL that will connect to your Appium server on 4723 port. And here we have set driver, new Appium driver, and URL and capabilities here. Now here you can also say driver equals new iOS driver, and you can pass the URL and caps, and this should also work fine. However, Appium driver will work both for Android and iOS. So I will just remove this, and I have also given manage timeouts, implicit wait of 30 seconds, and then the rest of the things are same as earlier. And if I go to the tests, you can see we have these tests here. In this earlier test, I am going to Google and then a login test. So let us see if this runs fine. And before that, I have to start the Appium server. So we have already done this. We have set up the device emulator. Now we have to start the Appium server. So I will go on my command and I will say Appium. In case I want to start on some particular port, I can say minus minus port and give the port number and say enter, or I will just say Appium and enter to start on the default port, which is 4723. You can also do it from the Appium desktop client. So you can see it has started on 4723, and in our commands also we are using the same port, 4723. So this is working fine. I will go to tests, do a right click, run as testng test. And now let us see, this should start and this should run the automation on our iPhone 10 simulator. So yes, this is running fine. It has opened Safari, and let's just wait. If your simulator is not already open, it will take some time, but because we have already started the simulator, it has now started our test. It is going to the orange HRM and will do the login. And this is done. And it is working fine until now. Although looks like it is having some issue in finding the next element, but that is fine. It will wait for the implicit timeout, and then it should start the next test. And yes, now it is going to Google and entered automation and Raghav, and yes, this is fine. And if I go back, you can see the console. So here there was one failure, and then the rest of the three tests are done. If I go to the results of testng, you can see there was one login test failure, and these are fine. And if I now go and do a right click on my project and refresh, and I'll say refresh, and if I now go to the test output folder, you can see the reports here. So I have index.html, and you can see all these reports. So there was one failure, and there were three pass. So all these details are there. If I go to the emailable report, you can see all the details here as well. And this is running fine. So this is how you can create dependencies for iOS automation, and you can run your test on iOS device. I hope this session was very useful for you. And if you have any doubts, you can put in the comment section below. But before you do that, always try to troubleshoot yourself. Put your doubt or copy your error statement and go to Google and try to search on your own. And then if you are having some issue which you are not able to resolve, you can always let me know. And I will meet you in the next session. Thank you for watching.